confession with their mouth, because the Savior said in Matthew 10 and verse 32 that whosoever therefore shall confess me before men, him will I confess also before my Father which is in heaven. Jesus said, if you confess me before these men, I'll confess you before my Father. And then he turns around and says, but whosoever shall deny me before men, him will I also deny before my Father which is in heaven. Jesus said, you must confess him as the Son of God. Jesus said, you've got to hear his word. Jesus said, you've got to repent of your sins. Jesus said, you have to believe in him as the Son of God. And then lastly, the fifth thing that Jesus wants you to do in order to be saved is to be baptized. When you look at Matthew chapter 28 and beginning at verse number 18, we see Jesus giving a commission to his disciples, and they're to take this commission and to go forth and do what it is that Jesus is commanding them to do. The Bible says, and Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, and all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. He says, go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I'm with you always, even until the end of the world. Jesus said that you got to leave this building. You got to go out there and teach them. And once you've taught them, what do you need to teach them? Teach them what he told you to teach them. Teach them that they must hear that he's going to be betrayed, that he's going to be killed, he's going to be buried, but he's going to rise again the third day. Teach them all that Jesus did, how that he healed the sick, and how that he raised the dead. Teach them one day 5,000 hungry souls he fed. Teach them how they treated him on that road to Calvary. And when they believe, that's step number two. When they believe what they heard from the word, then they got to change. That's step number three. That's repentance. And tell them that Jesus said, unless you change, then you're going to die in your sins. And then tell them that when you come with me to the worship service, you can do step number four. When the invitation is extended, we're going to give you the opportunity to come down the aisle and stand up before this congregation and confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. And then we're going to do step number five, which is baptize you in water for the remission of your sins. In Mark chapter 16 and beginning at verse number 15, Jesus once again tells his disciples, according to Mark's account, to go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Jesus said, he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, and he that believeth not shall be damned. A man got to be baptized. A man has to be washed in the blood of the Lamb. That's the reason in Acts chapter 2, when those men came to Peter and the rest of the apostles on the day of Pentecost and asked the men and brethren, what shall we do? That's when Peter told them to repent, change, and to be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of your sins. Peter said, then ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. What we're saying this morning is that when it comes to salvation, don't listen to some man who tells you the opposite of what God said. When it comes to salvation, you need to listen to the Savior. The Savior said, he told you what you needed to hear. The Savior tells us what we need to believe. The Savior tells us that we need to repent or change. The Savior said, you must confess him before men. And the Savior said that you must be baptized. Well, that's not going to change. As a matter of fact, when you look at Matthew chapter 24 and verse number 35, Jesus has already said that heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall not pass away. It doesn't matter that you may not like it. It's not going to change. Even if you refuse it, it's not going to change. Even if you reject it, it's not going to change. He says, heaven and earth shall pass away, but his word will never pass away, which means I've got to honor what Jesus says and do what Jesus says, just like Jesus said that it had to be done. I can't do part of it and say I'm saved. I can't do a pick and choose a piece of it and say I'm saved. If I'm going to be saved by the Savior, I've got to do everything that the Savior said I got to do in order to be saved. And then once you're baptized, the Bible indicates unto us that you're now in Christ Jesus. The Bible lets us know that God adds to the church daily those who want to be saved. Acts chapter 2 and verse number 47. And the Bible also indicates that the church is the body of Christ. Ephesians chapter 1 verses 22 and 23. So at the same time that God is adding you to the church, it's the same time that God is adding you to the body of Christ. That's the only way you can get into Christ, is that God has to add you into the body of Christ. And unless you're added to Christ, you're not in Christ. Unless you're added by God to the place that he has designated for the saved, then you are not saved. But if you've heard the word, if you believe what you've heard, if you're willing to repent of your sins, if you're willing to confess him as the Son of God, and if you're willing to be baptized this morning, then you'll be saved the way Jesus said you need to be saved, and you will have perks among men. Once Jesus saves you and once you're his, you've got something special. You've got access to his ear when other folk can't give him an answer. You've got spiritual blessings that are wrapped up in Christ Jesus that other folk just don't have. You've got promises, some special promises that God has reserved just for you because you are his child. For instance, in Matthew chapter 11, beginning at verse number 28, he says, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. He says, take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest unto your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. In Matthew 28:20, he said he'll be with us always, even unto the end of the world. And if we want him to be there, right there with us, we got to do what he says in Matthew 6:33. We got to seek him first and his kingdom. He says that all of these things will be added unto us as a child of God.
Amen.
Once I've become his child, once I've given my life to him, I belong to him, and I can depend on him to take care of me. If I'm ever in a situation where I can't take care of myself, see, that's one of the promises that God has given his children. He tells them, if I feed the birds, I'm going to feed you. He said, if I clothe the grass, I'm going to put clothes on your back. So don't worry about the